In this video, I'll guide you through building a real-time app using SignalR with Blazor. We'll demonstrate how to display the real-time geolocation of a mobile device and explore various options for sending notifications using SignalR. Let's dive in. First, we'll install the SignalR client library from NuGet packages. The library we're using is called Microsoft.ASP.NET Core SignalR.Client. After installing the library, we'll create a new SignalR Hub class named GeoLocation Hub. This class inherits from the SignalR Hub, allowing us to define methods triggered by SignalR clients. First, I'll demonstrate the server-side implementation, followed by the client-side setup. SignalR offers different methods to send message. Clients, all.sendAsync, broadcasts messages to all connected clients. We can assign the client method as the first parameter and pass the parameters needed. The clients.caller.sendAsync sends messages back only to the invoking client. SignalR also supports client grouping using groups.addToGroupAsync to add clients to specific groups. We can get the connection ID from the context. This method will add the client who invoked this method to a group named Group 1. We can also remove clients from a group. Now, this is how you can send messages to all the clients of a specific group. Next, we'll create a method to dynamically join groups with each device name serving as a unique group identifier. We'll be sending the device location from the MAUI app using Redis streams. I've already set up a service to read data from the Redis stream. The source code for this is available in our Patreon community, where you can download and refer to it. In this service, we obtain the SignalR Hub context as a dependency in the constructor and assign it to a private read-only object. This allows us to send messages via SignalR. We have a method called send notification, which is triggered when data is received from Redis. We'll broadcast this message to a group using the device name as the group identifier. The clients will listen for updates on the notify location update method, where we'll pass the latitude and longitude as parameters. Lastly, it's essential to map the hub in the program class. You can customize the hub URL pattern, which the clients will use to connect. Now, let's implement the SignalR client. On the homepage, we'll display the real-time location using the leaflet.js library to render the map. We'll start by placing a container component to load the map, and then we'll include a section for the necessary scripts. First, we'll add a JavaScript file named app.js, which contains the methods for initializing the map and setting the coordinates. In Blazor, SignalR client can be implemented in two ways, using C# code or a full JavaScript client. I'll demonstrate the C# approach first, followed by the JavaScript implementation. We'll begin by overriding the onInitializedAsync method and declaring a private hub connection object. In this method, we'll instantiate the object using hub connection builder and use the navigation manager to provide the hub URL we configured earlier in the program class. Next, we'll listen for messages, ensuring that the method name matches what we defined earlier. Using IJS runtime, we'll invoke the changeMarkerPosition JavaScript method, which is in the app.js file. We'll then start the hub connection and immediately call the joinGroup method. This ensures that messages are only received by group members, effectively invoking the method we created in the hub class. Finally, we'll override the onAfterRenderAsync method to load the map. We need to call this method when the page loads. Initially, I'll set the latitude and longitude to 0, but in a real application, you would display the previously identified location of the device. After adding the location reader service as a hosted service, and since I'm using Redis for data transactions, I've included Redis as a service as well. Let's test our application by running both the MAUI and Blazor apps. Once I click Start in the MAUI app, you'll see the Blazor app displaying the location on the map. I'll demonstrate real-time location updates shortly. Before that, let's implement the JavaScript SignalR client. We'll remove the C# implementation from the home page and switch to JavaScript. In the scripts section, include the SignalR library via a CDN URL, and we'll create the connection hub in JavaScript. We'll then listen for the notify location update event. When the event triggers, we'll call the JavaScript method to update the marker position on the map. Additionally, we'll handle the connection closing event and set up a method to reconnect if the connection drops. Let's implement the connect method. We'll start the connection and then invoke the join group method of our SignalR hub. We'll call the connect method from the onAfterRenderAsync method. Now, let's run the application and I'll show you the changing coordinates in real time. I'm running the mobile app on a real device that's currently in motion. As the data is received in Redis, the service sends the updates via SignalR, and you'll be able to see the real-time movements on the map. Don't forget to check out our Patreon community, where you can level up your skills and enjoy exclusive benefits. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. See you in the next video. Thank you.